Hey, it's Dr. Centeno, and on one of the Reddit subs, somebody had posted whether or not I was fear-mongering about the need for guidance and advanced training in cervical injections, because they just didn't see all of these people getting injured. I've seen many myself, including one that I got looped into. Didn't perform the procedure, but I got looped into it because I saw the patient. But long story short is, let's go to the medical literature. And here we find this paper, Injury and Liability Associated with Cervical Procedures for Chronic Pain. Now, this is a small professional society who decided to do a 2005 to 2008 closed claims project. This is an anesthesia society. And they were looking for malpractice claims to try to get a sense of what went on with cervical injections that led to a malpractice claim. And this is really the crazy part here. If you look at cervical procedures versus other chronic pain procedures, permanent injury was far more likely in cervical procedures, as was spinal cord injury. Makes sense. There's more to surgical procedures, and if they go wrong, they cause a bigger issue. So what kind of issues? The number one problem they saw was a spinal cord injury, and those were mostly permanent, including a spinal cord stroke due to an intra-arterial injection. That's the vertebral artery stuff I've been talking about for a long time. Infection, abscess, and a high block total spinal basically means the patient codes on the table. And if you don't resuscitate them, they'll be dead within minutes. So this paper supports exactly what I've been saying. I know there's all sorts of crazies on social media who try to argue that these procedures are not dangerous, that any idiot can do them, that you don't need guidance, et cetera, et cetera. And that's a social media narrative, especially here on Reddit. But it's critical to realize that that narrative is demonstrably wrong, and cervical procedures performed by poorly trained providers are dangerous. And cervical procedures performed by providers without imaging guidance are dangerous. And upper cervical procedures performed by all but a handful of physicians around the country are dangerous. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.
Hey, get this out to more patients by like, comment, share, subscribe. Thanks so much.